Hi, ladies, and welcome to week three of distance learning. I don't know about you, but I can't believe this is going to be our third week doing this, but hopefully we're all getting to be experts on learning online. So today I'm just doing an overall video, kind of like I did last week, because I'm not going to really talk specifically to individual classes this time because I don't really have a lot to tell you. We're just going to be sort of wrapping up things this week. And doing some of that on this new schedule that we're going to be kind of testing out for the week. So as always, I want to start out with a prayer. And I just thought today we could pray the Serenity Prayer. And I think it's a good one for this time when we're sort of struggling with the world around us. And of course, things going on in our personal life. And, you know, there are only so many things that we can control versus, you know, kind of what's happening. So I want to pray for someone very specific today. She is an alum of Notre Dame. She graduated in 1997. And she is I don't know her personally, but we're kind of doing a prayer chain. But she, her name's Alicia Jeffries, and she lives in Los Angeles, California. She is a nurse, and she is on the front lines, and she is struggling right now with the coronavirus herself. She was just hospitalized yesterday and at this point is not doing that great. So just keep her in your prayers and everyone else who is struggling with this horrible virus, to the families and to those that are on the front lines every day. Want to keep praying for them. So in the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. Amen. So I mentioned a prayer chain, and you may have noticed if you've been reading Mrs. Cullum's announcements every day, which I hope you have, that we prayed for Dr. David Mallory on Friday. And I don't know if it was really explained to you if you don't know who he is, but three of his daughters attended Notre Dame. The most recent was Emma Mallory. She graduated in 2017, so some of you might know that family. He's a pretty popular doctor here in the Toledo area, and some of you might even be his patient. But he was one of the like second or third diagnosed people in Lucas County with the coronavirus. And so miraculously, he was not doing that well last week and he was hospitalized, but he was released Saturday night. So I think that is really good news. And I wanted to share that with you since we were all praying for him. And, you know, I believe in the power of prayer. And I feel like when there is a lot of people praying for the same thing, I feel like, you know, we do see good results. So just keep praying and keep you know, thinking about those people that have been personally affected by what's going on. The other prayer intention was an alum, and we have a great Facebook group that just started last week in the midst of this crisis that someone, an alum created called Eagles Helping Eagles. Right now we have over 2,000 NDA alum, including myself, that are on this page, and it's, you know, women who graduated, you know, 50, 60 years ago to more recent grads, those that just graduated in 2019, and just reaching out to see like what we can do to help each other. And so it's really been inspiring to see all of our, you know, former alum who are, you know, doing awesome things. It's been a really inspiring, inspiring page. So that's kind of where some of our prayer intentions are coming from. And I know like the school knows about it as well. So I know that they're, you know, doing what they can at the administration level. That being said, the administration has decided to try out a different schedule this week. And so I'm hoping to see if that makes it a little bit easier for all of you. And so this week, it's not really going out of order because Monday would be the blue day anyways, but this week, Monday, Wednesday are blue days and Tuesday, Thursday are gold days. And then Friday is like a no color day. So that just means that teachers are not supposed to be assigning any new work on Friday. Friday is a day that you can work on whatever you need to catch up on. Just to clarify, it doesn't mean that things can't be due on Friday. So teachers can still assign things for you to upload and turn in on a Friday. They're just not going to be assigning. We don't have like class that day, and we're not going to be assigning like any new work. So just kind of keep that in mind. I did send out the weekly check-in. So I'm hoping that you have some time to fill that out and just to kind of check in with me to see how you're doing. Some of the questions are different from last time, just sort of seeing how week two was compared to week one. So far, there've been a lot of positive responses and that you're getting a little bit more comfortable with some of the things that might have been more of a challenge that first week. So hopefully we're kind of finding a groove. I would love to say that we're not gonna be doing this after spring break, although there is no official announcement from the governor in terms of what they're doing with the schools, which I'm pretty sure we'll find out while we're on spring break, maybe even later this week, because I think it was April 6th is the original date that was sent out. Or what the school's doing, you know, there's really nothing official there, but I kind of have a feeling we're gonna be doing this at least for a few more weeks after spring break. So hopefully, you know, again, this like new schedule this week's kind of a test, so we'll kind of see how that goes. I don't have a lot to tell you about like specific classes other than we're just kind of finishing up in US history, for example. We're just gonna keep going through the end of World War II. We're not actually gonna be done by the end of this week. There's really only one more topic that we're gonna take on this week, and that's the atomic bombs in Japan. And then we'll be wrapping up once break is over with that chapter. AP government, we are doing chapter 4, so it's civil liberties, and we're gonna be concentrating on that because we only have one more chapter before the test. Just remember this Friday, April 3rd, is when the AP College Board will be giving us more information about testing. And so actually any of you that are in AP classes, hopefully we'll know more at the end of this week. And again, get hopefully more information on Friday. And they're definitely sending us the two test dates to choose from to do it online. So we'll hear more from that. My regular government class, we are starting a whole new topic this week that we will absolutely not finish in a week because it's on the electoral process or elections and the Electoral College. So those are two pretty big in-depth topics. We'll see how far we get at the end of the week and then kind of wrap that up after spring break. One other thing I sent to you on Sunday was just an optional, if you're looking to reach out and do something nice for someone else while we're all kind of stuck at home. And if you have time to do this, I think it would be great. But there is, as I mentioned in the post, an alum who graduated in 2010 who reached out on our Eagles Helping Eagles Facebook page asking for anyone to send birthday cards or well wishes to her grandfather who is at Kingston Residence here in Sylvania, and he's a World War II veteran, former POW, so definitely a hero. We don't have that many World War II vets that are still living, and apparently he's pretty sharp, so he doesn't have dementia, he knows what's going on, but she said he's not very tech savvy, so he doesn't do social media, and he doesn't do any type of texting or anything like that. So and of course it's locked down and the family can't see him. So if you are interested in doing that, look for those directions on Classroom. If you, you know, feel free to pass that around if you know anybody else that would be interested in sending him a card. I think it would be a really nice thing to do. And finally, I know last week I mentioned sending something out about giving you some tips about distance learning and how to kind of overcome some of the challenges some of you are having with deadlines and organization and time management. So if you are doing well with that, then you don't have to listen to the rest of the video. But I just wanted to take a couple minutes and go over three things with you that I think would be really helpful for you if you are still struggling with those things. So the first thing I want to talk about is organization. And just to kind of give you a little insight into how I organize myself, when we're in school, I like have everything color-coded. So you may have never noticed that because it's just stuff that I use. But every class that I teach, so I have three preps, which means I teach three courses. So I teach US history and I have four US history classes, two on each day. I have AP government and I have a regular government class this semester. So those are my three courses that I have to plan for, and I have six classes. So every class period is color coded. So if you're in my AP class, you guys are aqua. And if you are in my period two gold day US history class, you're purple. So for me, color coding is a way that I remember things a lot easier. I'm also like, you know, history girls, if you had me for history in the past or currently, you know that I am a staunch believer in writing in pen, okay? So I am a big like pen collector. I have hundreds of pens and in all different colors. So I tend to, when I write things down, color code things as well. So that might be helpful for you guys if you have some colored pens or markers or pencils or something at home to assign like your course a color. If that's how maybe you can associate things more. So when you write things down, or if you're not writing things down, that's the next thing I'm gonna talk about, is writing things down. You can make those notes to yourself in a different colored pencil or pen or marker. So use the tools that you have, like your planner, okay? Hopefully you've been doing this. I know that, you know, with Classroom, it's easy to just sort of let things, like let the computer remember it for you, because Classroom's gonna send you out reminders, or you know that you have like stuff missing. But I still think, I'm a big believer in writing things down, writing down due dates, you know, using your calendar just like you would if we were in school, I think is really helpful to do that. I'm gonna show you, I'm gonna flip the camera here in a second, and I'm gonna show you what I'm doing as the teacher side of things, and you know, maybe this might work for you as a student. Okay, so we'll see how this goes. But this is my planner. I order a new planner every year, and the last couple years I've been using planners from a company called Erin Condren, and it's kind of a lot really geared towards like educators, but really like her planners. So I just want to show you kind of what I do. I got my like big March calendar, which I pretty much just put big X through that because like, heck, that doesn't even count anymore. Okay, so here's our first week that we did online learning. And so I kind of divide, like this page is all US history. And then this page is divided between AP government and regular government because I have you guys on opposite days. And so just, you can erase all of the, or don't pay attention to the career week stuff because I had that pre-filled before we started doing this. But basically what I'm doing is writing everything down, okay? So it doesn't look like a ton here because I also have another thing of notes that I keep for myself, but this is just gives me an outline of like things that we're kind of doing. So in US history, you know, we're doing notes on Pearl Harbor. The Pearl Harbor worksheet is due Thursday. So anytime I assign something, I immediately find that date, okay, that I'm assigned it, and I write down that it's due that day. That way, every day when I look at my calendar, I know that I need to go and look for those assignments because that's the day that it's due, okay? And again, I'm kind of color coding, so my gold day history classes are in purple, my blue day are in orange, and over here I got my government stuff. So like an AP, we did a current event, and they're doing like a blog discussion, and that is for the 20th, so I know. Now anything that's like the week before that, get rid of that. I'm sorry, the week after, I immediately go and say, okay, this is due, you know, this day. So this was like this past week. Now I gotta move into like April. So this coming week is kind of blank right now because today is actually Sunday when I'm recording this. So I've got the due dates though already for some of the stuff that I gave out from last week. So it's just an example of writing things down. If you don't like how the planner, what you got my planner over here? If you don't like how the planner has everything written, it is kind of a small space. You can always make your own calendar or just print something out. If you have a printer at home, or you can do something on your iPad that might work for you, or just, you know, take a sheet of paper and kind of make your own little calendar. I think that's really helpful. So the next thing was time management. And I think with writing things down, that kind of helps you. You know, the biggest tip I can give you for time management is to kind of create, I wouldn't say a rigid schedule. I don't want you to be like, oh, from, you know, 1:15 to 2:05, I'm going to be doing this. But I think having a plan, and I think maybe that we've been doing this for the last couple weeks, this week would be a great start to do, to maybe implement something like this, because you've been doing it for a while. So have a plan, like have an idea of, okay, today I know I have this due and this due. I'm gonna work, you know, an hour on government stuff, or I'm gonna work an hour on my chemistry homework, or whatever needs to be done. And also create some breaks for yourself. But if you write things down, that gives you a sense of all of the things that you have to accomplish. But it also gives you an idea of how much time things might take, and it allows you to sort of create a schedule for yourself. So, you know, if you're not getting up until noon every day, you know, you can kind of plan out how you want to do that. I know some of you that just can sit in front of the computer and do it all, you know, once, that's great. But I really recommend like taking breaks. I think it's really good for you mentally, whether it's just to take a walk outside, make sure you like do something exercise wise, you know, if you're doing like stuff online or just taking a walk. I think that's good as well, just to kind of give you a mental break. If you don't give yourself a plan, you know, then you're kind of planning to fail, or to end up being a disastrous. And, you know, I know a lot of you are struggling with motivation. My motivation for you is the fact that all of this counts. We are doing this, ladies, so we don't have to go to school in the summer, okay? So whether or not we go back after spring break, or if we have to end up finishing the school year doing this, it will still count for us in Ohio. So I think it's good that we live here, because in some states, they're not really gonna count online learning. So yay for us. So we gotta keep going. The last thing I wanna talk about quickly is just creating a workspace for you. I know that administration has sent out a couple of tips and things about, you know, not doing homework in your bed. And you might think, well, like I work fine in my bed, my bedroom. But, you know, if you look at the psychology of it and how your mind works, you know, when you are in your room, or you're laying on your bed and you're watching TV, or obviously you're sleeping in there, that is a connection for your mind not to focus and to relax, which is great because we all need a place to relax. But you also need a place to set up to focus. I'm in my office right now. This is where I tend to be when I'm at home and I have to do this kind of stuff. I know that when I'm in here, I'm not going to be sleeping. I'm not going to be watching television. So my second choice is my kitchen table, because sometimes I have to be out there if my daughter is in here working for school. So either one, I know like I have to be focused. And for you to have a place, it still can be in your bedroom if you have a desk, or maybe you have like a dresser that you could pull a chair up to make a workstation. Somewhere in your house, I think, that's quiet, that you know that when you sit in this spot, this is where you're going to be focusing on assignments and on homework. Well, that kind of ends our video for the week, and I hope that all of you have a great last week of online learning, at least for now, and a wonderful spring break that you get to relax. You don't have to worry about anything. Anything that we're doing this week is going to be due by the end of the week. So once you get done, you're done, and you get, what, like 10 days we get off. So it's kind of nice just to sort of have a break. This week, my kids are on spring break. So I know we're trying to find ways to keep busy, since we don't really get to do much of anything and going out and doing anything around town, but trying to stay busy here. So if you guys have any questions or any ways I can help you, I will be sending a last weekly check-in next weekend after we're kind of done with the week. And I hope you guys respond to that. I get a lot of like really good feedback and positivity through that, and I think it's a good way to kind of keep up with you guys. So feel free to email me any questions. I will be checking that throughout the week. So I shall see you soon. Have a great spring break.
You've got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old past said. Boy, you got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got trouble, and I got them too. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. We stick together, see it through, 'cause you've got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. Now some other folks might be a little bit smarter than I am, big and stronger too, maybe, but none of them will ever love you the way I do. It's me and you, boy. And as the years go by, our friendship will never die. You're gonna see it's our destiny. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me.